Hi everyone, welcome to Bonnie Carolee Makes Cards. I have a pair of interactive cards featuring Spellbinders Look Behind the Curtains and Daydreaming. I just recently subscribed to the Glimmer and Cut Value Club. This is definitely good value for money. I'm impressed. In these all die cut cards, there were a number of options that I could have chosen, but I had my design in mind, and so the first thing I did is pull all the dies that I was going to use from both sets. Bristol Smooth cardstock is ink blended with Distress Oxide inks for the window insets. For the daytime card, I'm using a combination of tumbled glass and squeezed lemonade. The sky for the nighttime card is ink blended with seedless preserves and chipped sapphire. I also ink up a section of squeezed lemonade and I cover it with cosmic shimmer to create some sparkly stars that will sit behind the nighttime sky. The inked areas, except for the yellow one, are cut with the window die cut. The nighttime inset panels are cut with the star die. There are three sentiment die cuts that coordinate with the frame that are included with the set. I have chosen Dream Big for one card and Wish Upon a Star for the other. White cardstock is used for the daytime card and black for the nighttime. Each sentiment is die cut three times so that they can be stacked for dimension. The frame die is also used on its own to create a white background for the daytime sentiment, and then I use the same cardstock for the curtains to create that background for the nighttime sentiment. I use the long curtain die and the scalloped valance to create my curtains. A pretty floral patterned paper is used for the daytime card, but for the evening card, I use a dramatic paper by Tonic Studios called Cinnamon Silk. These dies can also be used to add some foiling, which I did not think that I needed with the paper that I had chosen. With all my die cuts prepared, I am now ready to start working on the interactive element. The base panel for the evening card is cut from Simon Says Stamps Blue Violet cardstock to an A2 size. I will just be demonstrating how to build the interactive element with the daytime card. The die shown is used to create the slots by which the curtains will move back and forth. With the panel in a landscape orientation, I die cut approximately half an inch from the top. The panel was embossed with an embossing folder by Cuddlebug called Polka Dots. The three window frame die cuts are stacked together and then glued down to a piece of cardstock. The ink blended cutouts are inset back into the window frame. The base that it was built upon is trimmed to the size of the window. This die creates the sliding mechanism and also the curtain rod to pull the curtain back and forth. The L-shaped die will create the sliding mechanism. There are crease lines to indicate where to make the folds. These are inserted into the slit and wrapped around the bar. The two ends with the wrap fold need to meet in the middle. A little bit of double-sided tape secures the flap closed. I also use this strong adhesive to attach the curtain rods. The plain end of the curtain rod is butted up against the fold of the sliding mechanism. To ensure the slide moves freely, it has to be conditioned. The curtain rods are pulled back and forth quite a number of times, and I will do this again once the curtains are hung on them. To keep the curtain rod stabilized, I cut a very thin piece of foam, which is the length of the slits, and adhere it right underneath it. I leave the foam to completely dry before I move on to the next step. The curtains are attached, making sure that the one end meets up with the end of the fold on the curtain rod. By the way, the window is not attached yet, it is just there as a point of reference. A strip of foam about a quarter of an inch wide is glued to the top of the valance. The valance is then attached to the top of the curtain rod. Because the foam can take a while to dry and it can slip around, I'd make sure that I leave it to completely dry before I move on to the next step. The panel is attached to an A2 size card base. The card base is made from Nina Classic Crest 110-pound cardstock. I make sure to avoid getting any glue near the sliding mechanism. The rods are pulled back and forth just to make sure that nothing is impeding the sliding mechanism, and then I put the weight of my Misty on top to leave it to dry. After stacking the die-cut sentiments, they are mounted on a white base. I die-cut two of the kitties to sit on the window's ledge. I love that the heads are not attached so that you can tilt those heads any way you want. This die also comes with two tails so that you can have one going right and one going left. I love the thought that goes behind details like this. When the window is adhered to the card base, I make sure that I snug it up right against that foam strip. The little bit of foam that was showing at the bottom of the valance now looks like it's a part of the window frame. I'm big on using my Misty as weight. It just makes sure that everything is drying nice and flat. I wanted the ledge underneath the window frame to be a little bit higher so that the kitties would actually sit on it. I die cut a couple more of the white frames to add to the die cut sentiment. With that in place, the kitties were then glued to the ledge. A strip of foam square was used just to prop up the body of the cat against the window. I found a perfect secondary sentiment to go with Dream Big in a book of sentiments by Tim Holtz called Small Talk. The sentiments are self-adhering, so that was fast and easy. So the entire sentiment now reads, "Dream big, life was meant for a great adventure." And that's a wrap on these two fun interactive cards featuring Spellbinders' Look Behind the Curtains and Daydreaming. As always, I appreciate your visit.